Hello students, welcome to Brilliant Public School. The topic of today's discussion is differentiability. Let us go ahead with the required knowledge for this particular topic. In your previous class, you have studied that the function is differentiable if its limit exists and it is finite. Derivative of a function f is denoted by f dash of x. The function is not differentiable if its limit does not exist. Differentiation is nothing but the process of finding the derivative. We have already studied how to find the derivatives with the help of first principle. Let us recall now what is the definition of differentiability. Consider f be a real valued function defined on an interval I containing the point c. We say that f is differentiable at c if the limit x tends to c f of x minus f of c upon x minus c exists and finite. It means that if the limit does not exist, then the derivative of that function will not also exist. Let us recall what is the method to find the derivative of a function by first principle. Now the function which is taken here is x square. Definition of first principle says that derivative of a function f dash of x is defined as limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. The function is x square, so f of x plus h becomes x plus h whole square, f of x is x square. Substituting the values, and then we simplify the brackets, x square gets cancelled and we are left out with 2xh plus h square upon h. Further simplification eliminates h from the denominator and the function which is left is 2x plus h. Now applying the limit h tends to 0, which makes h is equals to 0, and we are left out with 2 of x. So by first principle we got that differentiation of x square is 2x. From this a general rule is derived that x to the power n's differentiation is nx to the power n minus 1, which can also be very easily derived with the help of first principle. Now let us come to some basic derivative rules. First is constant rule, that differentiation of constant is 0. Constant multiple rule, differentiation of constant with a function is nothing but taking out the constant, we differentiate the function, so we get as c f dash of x. Power rule, just now as we said, derivative of x to the power n is nothing but nx to the power n minus 1. Then sum and difference rule, derivative of sum and difference will be nothing but the derivative of the function along with the same operation, that is f dash of x plus g dash of x in case of sum, and in case of difference I would get f dash of x minus g dash of x. Now the two most important rules which we need to understand is product rule and quotient rule. Product rule is nothing but differentiation of a function which is in the form of product of two functions. We take first function into differentiation of second function plus second function into differentiation of first function. In this case, as the operation is addition, and addition is commutative, so it won't make any difference if you take the differentiation of first function or the second function in the beginning. Now, quotient rule is derivative of f of x upon g of x. Now it is understood, children, that g of x should not be equal to 0. In this case, it is not possible to take any of the function because minus sign is there and minus is not commutative. So I get denominator into differentiation of numerator minus numerator into differentiation of denominator upon square of the denominator. We are going to see these things in detail in the next slides. Chain rule again, f of g of x. It is f dash of g of x and then by chain rule g dash of x. Let us take an example to understand the product rule. See the example which is given here. I have two functions, x cube plus 2x plus 5 and 3x to the power 7 minus 8x square plus 1. So first bracket, taking it as a first function, we have differentiated it. Differentiation of x cube plus 2x plus 5 gives me 3x square plus 2, and the second function as it is. Then plus first function into differentiation of the second function, 3x to the power 7 gives me 7, 3 is a 21x to the power 6. Again we are using the same rule, x to the power n is n into x to the power n minus 1. So simplifying the bracket, you could see what is the final answer. The quotient rule is very easy to remember if we take it in the form of U and V. You can see in the lower box in the slide, we represent f of x as u and g of x as v. Then derivative of u by v is v into du by dx minus u into dv by dx upon v square. We can even say it as vu dash minus uv dash upon v square. So in this manner we can remember the quotient rule and solve number of questions using this rule. Now let us take up chain rule in detail. This is an example where function is x squared plus 1 to the power 1 by 2. If you observe, this is just as x to the power n, where in place of x I have x squared plus 1 and in place of n I have 1 by 2. So differentiation of that would be 1 by 2 x square plus 1 to the power 1 by 2 minus 1, and with the chain rule this g dash of x will be nothing but derivative of x square plus 1. Derivative of x square plus 1 will be 2 of x, and 2 will get simplified and the final answer which we will get would be x upon root x square plus 1. Definitely students, you people will be able to understand these rules when actually you are going to solve number of questions. Let us take one more example to understand chain rule. F of x is equal to under root of x plus 3, where f of x is x plus 3 to the power 1 by 2. We have rewritten this thing as exponent. Again using the same rule, x to the power n, I apply the chain rule further by differentiating x plus 3. Here differentiation of x plus 3 is 1, so I get very easily the answer as 1 upon 2 root x plus 3. Now to understand these rules very clearly, we need to practice a lot taking the questions and applying product rules, quotient rule and chain rule. So first solve number of questions children, and then we will proceed with the next concept in the next video. Thank you everyone, and